We are coming to the final days of the 16 Days of Activism, which is an annual international campaign which commenced on the 25th of November. That was the International Day for the Elimination of Violence Against Women, and it's running right through until the 10th of December, which is Human Rights Day. Throughout this period, we are reaching out and have been reaching out each and every day to communities across Ireland, offering support, reassurance and protection to victims of domestic, sexual and gender-based violence. As we know, domestic, sexual and gender-based violence is a crime, and it's important to know throughout all our messaging that we in An Garda Síochána, we're here to listen, to protect victims and to prosecute those who perpetrate those crimes. As part of our activities, we are conducting operations focused on human trafficking investigations and the purchase of sexual services, sexual crime and intimate image abuse, and this morning Sinead will speak to you in detail in respect of domestic, sexual and gender-based violence and specifically coercive control investigations conducted by An Garda Síochána. We in An Garda Síochána are working really hard and we are absolutely committed to our relationship and our engagement with victims of crime. We need to understand the vulnerabilities of those victims, their families, and we must recognise the enormous step that a victim has taken in contacting An Garda Síochána. We must then give them the protection, support and reassurance that they deserve. Most importantly for us, we need people to keep coming forward, to keep talking to us, to keep engaging with us. And in that engagement, we will try and build a real sense of trust and allow the investigation to proceed.
As we approach the end of the 16 days of activism against gender-based violence, An Garda Síochána continue to see domestic abuse as a high volume and high impact crime. Since the commencement of Operation Fuisheamh at the beginning of the pandemic, we saw and continue to see an increase in the number of reported domestic abuse cases. So far this year, we have recorded 49,257 reported incidents relating to domestic abuse. And this represents a 9% increase year-to-date when compared to 2021. The reality of this figure is that An Garda Síochána respond to a domestic abuse-related call approximately every 10 minutes. We are conscious that domestic abuse is an underreported crime, and that's why we are here today to raise awareness. While it would appear that there is an increased awareness of coercive control in society, there may be still some uncertainty about this offence and what it means. In January 2019, coercive control was included in the Domestic Violence Act, recognising the psychological abuse that causes fear of violence or serious alarm or distress on a person's day-to-day life. Coercive control is a pattern of behaviour that involves humiliation, intimidation, leading to psychological or emotional abuse that may not include any physical violence at all. It involves a current or ex-partner that is or was in an intimate relationship with the victim. While not exclusive, coercive control behaviours can include restricting the victim's movements, excessive contact or monitoring of phone activity and social media, controlling the victim's finances, imposing rules and forcibly making decisions on their behalf. And even though this is a relatively new offence, the sad reality is that there are people living with this in their lives for years and decades. We in An Garda Síochána want victims of domestic abuse and coercive control to know we are committed to tackling domestic abuse, no matter who the abuser is. As we approach the Christmas period, I would urge anyone who is concerned for a friend or family member or who is a victim of domestic abuse or coercive control to please come forward and speak to a member of An Garda Síochána. We are here to protect, prevent and prosecute, and An Garda Síochána are committed about pursuing domestic abusers. We understand that a victim of domestic abuse may find it daunting to make contact with a Garda station or ringing the Gardaí. And if that is the case, there are excellent support services available that can help until the victim feels they are ready to make that contact with the Gardaí. We have seen that with each year, the numbers of reported coercive control incidents and indeed convictions are increasing, which show the impact of the legislation and that victims are gaining confidence coming forward and reporting these incidents to the Gardaí, which is encouraging.